in this season of creation, that we really are part of this earth. Lauren's message reminding us of the two creation stories. There's one where God's a God on high and whispers a word and something's created and he looks and sees that it is good. And then we have this other creation story where God is more like a farmer or a gardener and gets around in the dirt and digs into the dirt, and out of that dirt creates the human. You know, every time we have an Ash Wednesday liturgy, part of the liturgy is that we will impose ashes on people's foreheads or the back of their hand if they choose it. And usually we say something like, from dust you came, unto dust you will return. Or you are God's, and to God you will return. It's a reminder. Not so much about our mortality. I mean, yes, we're all going to die. But it's more about how we are related to each other, how we are related to the earth, and how we are related through that to God. We are all connected. Each of us. All of us. One of the joys of the work we do here at Pilgrim is to have a very vital group like the Green Team who lifts up for us, not just in September each year, but throughout the year, the things that we can do to not be panicked about what's going on, to not feel totally out of it just because the leader of the free world has turned his back on the Paris Accords. They help us remember that there is something each and every one of you, each and every one of us, can do every day to have a positive impact. Some years ago, there were quite a few jokes going around about people ordering specialized drinks at a store like Starbucks. Half, calf, decaf, upper, lower, whatever, tall, medium, small, whatever. I find that my order changes dramatically when I pay attention to what Cleo was saying to us. So I step up to the barista and say, iced coffee, for here cup, no straw. Right? We don't want that extra packaging. I want to drink my coffee, put the glass back on the counter, and say, see you. I don't want a straw going around in the world and wreaking havoc, a tiny little straw wreaking havoc, because that's what they do. Cleo and the Green Team remind us, empower us, to be part of God's creation, to be an ally for God's creation. It's in our genes to be an ally with the environment, with other people. This morning, a man came to the door. It happens from time to time. And I was the one who was at the door. And he had a story. And I took him to my office and I listened to his story. He just needed a little bit. Was able to give it to him. He was grateful. My guess is we'll never see this man again, even though I invited him to worship and to come to church anytime he wanted, and he appreciated that. This man felt alone when he came to the door. He said he didn't know what made him come to the door. I think the door was actually open, and it's not always open this early in the day, but he came to the door. Came in, and someone interacted with him like he's just another human being. Not somebody that you want to avoid, just another human being. That's what we do for each other, right? That's what we do for each other in this space. That's what we do for each other in the community. I received an email on Friday, I think it was, Saturday, I don't know, my class. All these days just sort of rushed together. And it was an invitation, if we were able, to join a couple of our colleagues in a gentle protest, and that's how it was identified, for Monday afternoon outside of Moody Bible Institute. Moody Bible Institute has signed on to the Nashville testimony, which, right, it takes the LGBT community and demonizes them. And the United Church of Christ has stood against that as soon as it came out. I've signed on to that letter with the United Church of Christ. We've been invited, if we're able, to come to a 3:30 to 4:30 protest. And the colleagues who were writing said, perhaps by our being there, it will provide a light for some of the gay students at Moody Bible, because they're pretty sure there's some gay students at Moody. And maybe it will lift up this, shed a different light, tell a different story, which is what we do, right? We stand up, we tell a different story, just like the Green Team is telling a different story each day for us, just like Warren helped us look at the creation stories differently this morning. Right, it's God in the dirt. We stand with the earth. We stand with our colleagues. So I forwarded that email to a few people, who forwarded it to a few more people. And we get a note back, I think I can be there. Is there anything I can take that will identify me as Pilgrim Church? Oh, we're working on that. But isn't that how it works? One person asks another person, and another person asks another person, and another person, and it gets out there. Social media can be our ally when we use it correctly. It helps us stand for the environment. It helps us stand for the LGBTQIA community. It helps us stand with people on the margin. It empowers us to do this. And not to be overwhelmed, oh my goodness, no, each of us can't do everything that's possible, right? In fact, my response to these folks was, I would love to be there, I can't be there, but let me communicate with some other folks. And I didn't know if anyone would be able to be there. Someone would be there. And I'm grateful for that. That is so important to who we are. All this month, all the month of September, we will focus on creation. We will focus on the environment through worship, through educational programs, through fellowship, through the whole thing, through the life of the church, so that it becomes part of who we are. And we identify those ways, those big ways, those small ways, in which we can make a difference in the world. This text that they give us today is a text of, actually, it's lament. It's, the scholars believe that it was a song that was written for someone who was feeling like they were erroneously accused of not standing with God. And it's a psalm for them to take into the temple and to speak their concern. It is this incredible psalm, right? Where can I go that you won't know that I'm there? Where can I hide from you? I cannot hide from you. Oh my God, I am part of you, and you are part of me. If I go to the heavens above creation, or I go to Sheol below creation, if I go to the rising sun or the setting sun, you are there. I cannot escape. I hope that the people who are facing Irma and the people who are preparing for Jose have this psalm written on their heart so that they know that God is with them in the midst of this terror. That God is with them. I hope that the students at Moody Bible Institute who may be LGBTQIA, maybe that they have this written on their heart. And they know that no matter what some people are saying, that they are part of God and God is part of them. Your right hand shall hold me fast, always. I cannot define you when I am amidst dark, dark is like light to you. You are more than I can understand, and yet, just like you created us out of the dirt, I am part of you. And you are part of me. That is how we live our lives. Not in a bubble, isolated from other people, isolated from the earth, isolated from the world. We cannot live that way. We stand up. We speak. We support each other and those on the margins, including the earth, which is being in one. God is part of us, and we are part of God. Carry this song in your heart. As you read reports of what's happening along the southern coast, as you wonder what's going to happen next with North Korea, as you are concerned about people on the margins, let this song empower you to show up, to stand up, to speak. That's what we do. We're Pilgrim Church.